Good afternoon. This afternoon we will be taking a look at the Sealine T50 Her Outdoors. Built 2006, powered by a pair of Volvo D9 575 horsepower diesel engines. So an updated nav kit. You see she's also got backlit lights for the name on both port and starboard, and one on the transom as well. Nicely specified boat this. With bow thruster, stern thruster, as I say, updated navigation equipment, Passerelle 11 kVA generator, teak decks all round, teak cockpit, teak bathing platform, teak flybridge. Some of the flybridge upholstery has been updated as well. But how would you describe a T50? One word: big, massive accommodation space, very, very comfortable, three cabin boat. And this example is in pretty good order throughout, and certainly if you're looking for a family flybridge cruiser, the T50 hits an awful lot of boxes. So now inside the cockpit, first thing you see if you step in is this lovely triple pane sliding door. Very solid, works incredibly well. Then you've got what can only be described as quite a spacious cockpit area. Now, Sealines of this era had an extending cockpit system whereby this bench seat extends back onto the bathing platform, giving you a little bit more cockpit space. So if you've got a few more people around to party, you can accommodate them. As you'd expect, you've got lovely curtsy lights everywhere, both high and low, up the flybridge steps as well. And if we go up onto the flybridge, you'll see some in the radar arch as well. Forward-facing radar arch, a little bit unusual, quite iconic with the T50. What we have got is a very big flybridge extending table, nice seating area at the stern here, and grill and fridge, and then a helmet navigator seat. This memory cover, absolutely useless today, but with the sun shining, I'll be very grateful for it. Standing up here, this central helm position, you get a real clear idea of the visibility. Absolutely superb. You can see as well, full deck, the little teak laid. You see as well actually how easy the decks are to get round. Nice wide side decks on this boat. Okay, let's take a look inside. Stepping through the patio door, we've got the main saloon. Plenty of glass in this saloon area, hence the blinds, but lots of natural light. You can see we've got a, on the starboard side here, large fridge freezer, and good storage. And then to port, got a nicely appointed galley with the control centre above. This era, Sealine had the C-Plex system, so everything's controlled on the touch panel. This boat as well, we've got some air conditioning as well as heating. So for the summer we've just had, absolutely perfect. And now we're going into the winter months, we've got the heating as well. Large saloon table, which obviously you can use for eating. You get quite a few people around this. And the table is on a electric high-low system that can also be pulled out the way, so you move it around to get easy access into the seat and onto the seating. Now the seating here on the port side is freestanding, so that will pull across So if you've got a few more, then you know you get sort of four or five around the table as it is. If you've got a few more to party, you can just pull the seat across and have a have some more people sat at the seats. So like so. And clearly, good place to hide the good wine. Now, the lower helm position. Again, the first thing you notice sitting down with these skylights is just how light and bright it is down here. And yes, we've got the lights on because it's a bit of a dim day, but it's still incredibly bright and light. Nice clear instrumentation. As you can see, we've got updated Raymarine nav kit, bow thruster, stern thruster. So we've got plotter, radar, everything you need, autopilot, and these will be a depth and speed. The bow and stern thruster conveniently are also on the remote control here as well. Engine hours, port we've got 961 and starboard 952. Okay, so following this spiral staircase down, we've got the three cabins and two toilet showers. The layout's quite simple. Forward cabin, big island double bed. With hanging space, as well as, well, storage lockers all over. And with a door through to the toilet and shower compartment. Again, like the whole boat, really good size, full sailing headroom. And a proper shower stall. And then opposite the toilet and shower to port, we've got the two bunk beds. Perfect for kids. And again, they have got their own hanging locker space. So at the foot of the spiral stairs, you've got this, what can only be described as a larder. Absolutely brilliant storage. Ideal if you're going away any different length of time. And below that, your washer dryer. Again, very well thought out storage space on this boat, making use of every spare inch that they can. So aft, we've got this full beam master cabin. This, in my opinion, really sets the T50 apart from its competition. Yeah, it's lovely. What can you say about it? It's, you know, you've got plenty of storage space. Enormous great bed. Got these nice hull windows as well. And of course, a very generous ensuite. Again, with a separate shower stall and, well, ample headroom. So that has been the T50. Called Her Outdoors. In summary, very well specified boat. I mean, you can see he's got Fusion upgraded speakers everywhere, Fusion systems. We've got generators, we've got bow thrusters, stern thrusters, modern nav kit, washing machines, passerelle, the Sealine extending cockpit system, teak everywhere. Yeah, very nice boat, in good order. But what you really can't go on enough about is the actual space on board. Very, very spacious, very comfortable cruising boat. If your family is looking to upgrade from something, say, 40 to 43 feet, you want a bit more space, you've got a bit more time to go longer distance cruising, then the T50 really is well worth a look. Thanks for watching. Full details can be found at www.nya.co.uk. Just hit the tab for used boats.
Thank you.